In this video, let's create a pivot table using PIVOTBY function in Excel. And I'm going to be using this data set. And just to give you the comparison between the two, I'll basically just start by making a report using a pivot table from this data. And then I'll do that using PIVOTBY function in Excel. So with a pivot table, it's going to be straightforward. We're going to just select this data. We're going to go to Insert menu, and I'll go to Pivot Table on top here. This is the range of data. It's going to ask me where to place the actual report. So here I'm going to go Existing Worksheet, and I'll put that right here. Hit OK. And what I'll do, I'll take Sales column, and I'll drop it in Values. And as you can see, what it's doing sum of those sales amounts. So it's summing the sales. Now, if you wanted a different function, you could right click, go summarize values by, and do count or average or other functions. But here I'm going to go back to sum. That's good. And then I'm going to take the sales rep column and drag it to rows. So this is now our total sales by rep. And then finally in columns, I'm gonna use region. So I'll take region, drop it in columns. And as a result, we get total sales by region. And that's how we do this using a pivot table. So we got our value field being our sales, function being sum, rows is sales rep, and columns region. If you're not familiar how to create pivot tables, I would highly encourage you to watch a separate video about pivot tables. But now let's do this using PIVOTBY function. So I'm gonna start with equals PIVOTBY. And here, the first one is gonna be row fields. So if you remember when I was building this pivot table for rows, I chose sales reps. So I'm gonna choose this sales rep column. And right now I'm including the first row as a header, which you have the option to not include. But right now I am going to include that, comma. The second part here is column fields. And that would be here. See, we have this Midwest, West, all these regions. So that's going to be region. So I'll select that, comma. And then the third part is value field. If you remember, that was sales. So I would take sales column. And then with those values, we used to sum them. So after comma, we're gonna basically choose the function we want to apply to that values field. So in this case, I'll do sum. Here, you're gonna do a function with no execution, meaning no open close parentheses, just sum like this. And then I'm gonna go comma again, and this is where I'm going to say whether we have headers as the first row or not. And in my case, I did include headers, so I'm going to say either yes but don't show or yes and show. And here I'll go yes and show, and I'll show you what the differences are. So I'll go yes and show, and the rest of these I'm just gonna close parentheses for now, hit enter, so you can see what we get. We get our reps listed here, we get our regions listed here, and then we get our totals and also grand totals. So essentially, it's the same thing. Now, we can go back here to this formula, and instead of this 3, which is where I said yes and show, I'm gonna say yes but don't show. And with this, it will basically just not include that top part here, the part that said region and sales and all of that. It will simply just give us, this is the region by region, this is the reps, and this is our totals. Now, you also have the option to not display totals if you like, so you can go back here, and after this, you can do another comma, and here you can either choose to display your totals or not display totals. So if I do no totals, hit enter, it should basically not include this totals down here, but you can see we still have these totals over here. And for those, if I go back here and choose comma, it's gonna ask me for the sort order for rows. So this is positive or negative number if you want it ascending or descending. I don't care right now, I'm just gonna go comma. And then we have this column total option. So once again, I'm gonna say no totals for this too. And this way, there is also no totals here. Now, if you start by selecting this different ranges, not including the header. So let's say you started here in line two and here in line two and also here in line two. Essentially, it's the same thing, but this first line is not headers. So in that case, what you would need to do is go here and after the sum and comma, when you choose your headers, you're going to say either no or no but generate. So basically we're saying the first line is not headers in our data. For example, if I do no here, hit enter, it would basically get me the same thing. Just make sure you match with your selection. If you include headers, you're gonna have to say that we have headers. If you don't, you're gonna have to say that you don't have headers. Now, if you decide you want to do a different function, let's say in a pivot table, if you wanted to do, instead of sum, you wanted to do the average, you could right click, go summarize values by, and switch to average. So for that, we can go here. And in this formula, instead of sum, we can just use the function average. And if I hit enter, we should be getting the same thing. Finally, if I right click and go count this, so to do count, you're gonna have to use the function counta, not count. Count is numeric count only. The regular count in pivot tables actually does counta. So I'm gonna hit enter. And once again, we should be getting our count by rep, by region. So what is the difference? So the difference is, number one, unlike a pivot table, this is a formula, so it will update as we change our data immediately. So for example, if I go here and change this Edward to Anna, you'll see immediately this updates with our new report and we have Anna, but if you look at our pivot table, it does not, because regular pivot tables in Excel don't automatically update. And sometimes that's a good thing, because when you start working with super large spreadsheets, you don't want this to recompute every time because it takes a lot of processing power. But in a lot of cases, you may want it to update. Now, here I would have to refresh it. So I'm gonna have to right click, refresh this, and see now Anna appears in this report. So that's one difference, how refreshing works. But then also formula version is gonna be a lot more flexible in the type of functions you can actually apply to this. So if I go here on the regular pivot table and right click, and you see what options we have, you're gonna see we have sum, count, average, max, min, product. Then there is this more options. So let me just click here so you can see that. And under more options, we have product, count numbers, which is equivalent to regular count instead of counta, a couple of standard deviations, and variance function. And that's it. So this is the full list of functions you can apply for a regular pivot table. Now for a pivot by function like this, we have a lot more flexibility in our functions. So if I open this list, you can see we have things like, for example, median, which you wouldn't be able to do. And there is a lot more choices here in addition to that. And then finally, to top this all up, there's also lambda. So if this list is not enough, you can always use lambda function to generate your custom functions and sometimes combination of multiple functions to apply more complicated formulas to this. So to give you one example here, I'm gonna hit escape for a second to get out of this. So let's say we change these functions to sum for a second. And this one too, I'm gonna change to sum. And if I, for example, had certain sales amounts here that are not numbers, even though they look like numbers. So for example, if I go here and start adding some apostrophes here to convert these to text, not a number. So what's going to happen for those? You're gonna see for Anna, for example, right now, over here, it doesn't calculate that number because it's no longer a number, it's text. And if I refresh this pivot table, you'll see the same thing. For Anna, it gives me zero. It doesn't actually calculate this. So now we can convert that to a number first and then apply the sum function to make this actually work. And to do that, I can go back here and take this sum, and instead of sum, I can use lambda function, which allows you to generate new functions. And with lambda function, it's super complicated. I have a separate video just going over it. I would encourage you to look into that to just understand how lambda works. But here I'm gonna go x as a variable, as a parameter, comma. And then the next parameter for lambda is what is it that we want to do with that parameter. And here I'm gonna say, let's sum and value that x parameter. So I'm gonna close parentheses for value, close parentheses for sum, and then close parentheses for lambda. So value function here, it's gonna convert that variable to a number, and then sum is gonna do our regular sum. And with this, if I'd enter, you'll notice that we're able to get those totals because we're able to convert it to a number first and then also apply a sum function to this to get our results. So now we have this flexibility of lambda function to be able to create new functions using the entire list of Excel functions we have in our disposal, which you couldn't do with a regular pivot table. Now, in this example that I did, when I was creating a pivot table, I did end up using columns and rows. Now, sometimes when you make a pivot table, you may end up not using columns and you just have rows. So for example, if I take this region out of here, that will be just total sales by rep. So we're not using columns. And for cases like this, you can use group by function instead of pivot by function. So group by will allow you to do this sort of report. Essentially, it's a type of report where your pivot table doesn't have columns section, and pivot by is when you have columns. Now for group by, I'm just gonna publish a separate video. And in that video, I'll go a little more in depth about this lambda functions and what kind of things you can do with it. So if you're interested into looking more into this custom formulas here, I would encourage you to watch that video. But here I'm gonna stop at that with this lambda. That's good enough. And the last thing I wanna go over here is what if you want to add a filter? So let me put that region back here. And let's say you wanna take this report and you wanna filter it by store. So I'm gonna take this store, drop it in filters, in the pivot table. And let's say now I'm gonna go up here and filter this to one of the stores. So I'll go here and say, let's look at art dress. Hit okay. And these are my totals now for art dress store. Now, if I wanted to do this here with a formula, what I can do, I'm gonna go back to this. And after this column total depth argument, we have the next argument. Let's actually go here in the formula bar. It's gonna be easier to follow this because it's gonna be bigger. So if you look at this formula, so you can see column total depth here, Then I'm going to do comma here, and it's going to be sort order for columns. Again, negative or positive number. And I'm going to skip that one too, comma. And finally, we have this argument, filter array. And this is where you can do true and false array to filter what you want to keep and what you want to take out. So for example, if I wanted to keep address only for store, I would basically select this list of stores and check if it equals address. Like this. And this will be that array of trues and falses, and trues will stay and falses will disappear. So as a result, if I enter, see, we get the same thing. Of course, here you get a repeat because we have grand totals here too, which I did take off for my formula, but you can see we get the same results. So if you wanted to add a filter, you have the option to do so. And again, if you're on a smaller screen and you're having a hard time reading this, just look in the formula bar. It's gonna be a lot easier to read. And there you go. That's your PIVOTBY function. If you want to get a little more in depth into this, I would encourage you to look into group by video that I'm going to do separately. And that should do it for PIVOTBY. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.